any stomach sounds you might hear in this video usually doesn't happen too often in my videos, but last night we had burgers and dogs for dinner. So good. With onions. I shouldn't have ate the onions. But we are well past it. This is like 15 hours later, and my stomach is still kind of making little pops and gurgle sounds from the onions. Anyway, TMI, right? Too much information. Good now. I hope you're doing well. A little eldritch horror with a kind of like looking like this, actually. Like a snake body, a head covered in writhing tentacles. I think it had one eye. I didn't see a nose. And then an upside down mouth. And it kind of whispered to me that you, and yes, I mean you, watching or listening or doing both at the same time, that you might not feel confident at certain times. Is that right? Or do I have to go and strangle that eldritch R, and unlife it? So it was speaking the truth. Okay. Now, listen, I don't want to talk to you as if you're not smart. I'm not trying to talk down to you. I know that you, however old you are, although I'm kind of thinking maybe this might be geared towards younger people. I know you're very smart and capable of figuring things out, how to be confident, okay? But I thought I would make this video. This isn't directed to anyone in particular, okay? Or about anyone or anything. I don't know how it sprung up, but confidence. Oh, I know how this sprung up. A lot of... There's a plane passing overhead. It might be a drone spying on us. Okay, I think we're safe. So, you know, a lot of this alpha male, sigma, cringy, these, I want to be nice, but these people who feel insecure, right? So let's make it a scale. So when you feel insecure, or you feel whatever, what do most people do? You go to the other extreme, the polar opposite, to try to balance it out. So that's partly how this idea, the eldritch R did whisper in my ear, my good ear, about you possibly needing to hear this message. So that's part of it. But the other part is a lot of this alpha male, Chad, King, Sigma, even, all these nonsense people, mostly men who are insecure, and so they go to this extreme to balance that out. Like I said, I'm not saying that's you, but that's part of the reason why I'm here and I wanted to talk to you or whisper to you. I have no problem louder. This isn't a, you know, I whisper not because of a lack of confidence, but I whisper just because it's what I do. So there's plenty of videos and people that talk very loud, and I could easily do that. I've done that in my podcast, but, you know, do ASMR. You can get plenty of advice and confidence talks and life advice from plenty of loud, normal volume folks, but I'm going to do things a little different. All right. So aside from all the, well, maybe we'll get back to the how we balance things in our lives and how we feel, but enough about all the alpha, sigma, king, cringy nonsense. So I'm going to talk a little bit about, share my own personal experience with confidence, a lack of confidence, and how I've gained more confidence. Now you are, I know you're very confident in who you are most of the time, but there are times when you don't feel very confident, right? Maybe there's just one particular day you wake up, you feel more vulnerable. You don't feel like, maybe you didn't sleep well. You just don't feel very confident. It could be because the sun is not out and it's cloudy. There could be any number of reasons why you might not feel confident in yourself. Maybe it's an everyday thing. Maybe it's on occasion. So many different circumstances. But for me, when I was young, I felt I wasn't confident, feeling self-conscious, and feeling a lack of confidence only affected me when I was standing in front of a group of people having to talk. Even in my 30s and 40s, at certain office jobs, social settings, having to just be around people I didn't know, having to do a presentation at an office job meeting, very nerve-wracking. But when I'm not in those situations, I'm very confident. So it's not, it somewhat, when you're young, it can be somewhat of a lack of self-esteem, which was the case for me sometimes. Like I said, you, myself, anyone, were not self-conscious or lack self-esteem or have no confidence all the time. There's plenty of times, like I said earlier, there's plenty of times where you, myself, so many people are confident and secure. But there's always those moments, 5% of the time, throughout any day or week, when we just don't feel very confident. And so I want to try to help you in some way find the, you know, I can't really make you gain confidence or self-esteem in yourself. That's something that you have to work on. But you have my support. A lot of these videos that I do, that's all I really can do, is try to give you some support. You know, kind of right? I know I'm a father, and you know, I've had these annoying dad talks with our son, not to this great of a length, but I'll pull my son aside, or I'll, you know, go into his room, just playing a video game or whatever, and I'll be like, hey, you got a second? And I just talk, and he's like, yeah, I know. He knows everything, right? When we're kids, we know everything, right? Even though we don't know everything. So, but I'm not trying to treat you like a child, even if you are a child. That's kind of how we raised our son, one of us. You know, even though not on the same knowledge and experience level just yet, son, maybe you, just because you're young and inexperienced and less knowledgeable about the world doesn't mean you're stupid. You can be uneducated, but not stupid. You might be naive to what goes on in the world, but that's not a stupid thing. And I've been known to call people stupid because people can be frustrating. And I don't want to get into the whole thing about lack of education and all that. I could easily go down that path. I mean, in regards to people not lacking education, being taken advantage of, that's a problem in society. When the people, the smart people, the people with the knowledge and the education, know or take advantage of the vulnerable, the less educated. That's what I don't want to get into. Anyway, I forget what I was just talking about. So let's kind of reset here. So I've had friends. You know, I wasn't like some insecure, low self-esteem kid all the time. Just certain moments, like I'm sure you might understand. And so, and like the thumbnail in the video shows with the hands in the pockets and kind of looking down, I want to share just a brief little story, a little something my father said to me way back in the 80s, 70s, maybe, when I was about 8, 10 years old, impacted me very much, was probably the most important thing my father ever said to me. I'll never forget it. Very impactful. And I think all he said was like 2 or 3 words. Keep your head up. Because I used to kind of walk, like staring down. And I don't want to get into the whole thing about my father. Obviously, my parents are from the, they were born in the 50s, early 50s or late 40s. So a lot of men, males from that time period aren't like males from today, like myself. Nothing against them. A lot of us are more talkative and expressing emotions and things like that. So, but then again, there are still plenty of males today who aren't very touchy-feely, you know, into giving hugs and all that. But let's not go down that path either. I don't want this video to be an hour. Okay, so So I used to, like you see in the thumbnail, I used to walk with my head down, probably my hands in my pockets, and then I started to, you know, walk with my head up. And so that's one thing you can do. I don't know, like I said, I don't know what type of lack of confidence or self-esteem that you may or may not have. Maybe you walk around with your hands out of your pockets and with your head up, and that's great. Maybe you have confidence issues in other ways, standing up in front of people or something, who knows. So I'm not going to go over all the myriad ways in which someone, the many examples of ways and we can be self-conscious or lack confidence or lack, be self-conscious, lack confidence or lack self-esteem. There's a lot of different scenarios, but I just want to have this little talk. Like I said, there was that eldritch horror writhing tentacle headed thing that told me that you might be feeling a little, you know, a little bit here and there. You don't feel very confident. So that's the first thing. If you happen to be someone that walks with your head down, and especially if you're somewhat antisocial like me, I don't hate people, but I'm not a people person. I'm kind of like, if I have to interact with people, I will, you know, hello. As I'm walking by someone, you know, little small exchanges, you know, but that's enough for me. I mean, I've had plenty of friends, co-workers and stuff throughout my life, so it's not like I'm completely antisocial, but I just, you know, where I am now, I'm to the point where I'm confident that I don't need friends. That's not to say I don't want to be friends with people who would like to be friends. I would love to, but you can't be friends with everyone. So I prefer to be an island. I like that. I'm not saying I like that phrase. I like being kind of solitary and minimizing my interactions with people and all that. Okay, so enough about me. But maybe that, you know, I say all this because maybe you can relate, okay? So that's one thing, is walk with your head up. Even the reason that's important is for two things. One, you walk with your hands out of your pockets just by your side, you know, as you normally walk. So you have your hands at the ready for self-defense, just for anything, in case you trip and fall. If you have your hands in your pockets and you're walking and you trip and fall, or someone comes up or anything happens, there's going to be a little bit of a delay there to get your hands ready, and it might be too late. Not really. I mean, you can pull your hands out of your... I'm analyzing now the time that it takes to someone to pull their hands out of the pockets to, in case they're tripping and falling another plane. Usually I edit this out, but whatever. So that's the two reasons for walking with your head up. You don't have to necessarily keep your eye level, you know, and look at people. You can still look down. When you have your hands out of your pockets and you have your head up, even though you know, even if you're listening to headphones, especially if you live in an area that might not be very safe, or you're alone on a walk, especially if you are not very strong, whether you're male or female or whatever gender orientation it might be, doesn't matter. That's another reason to be confident in yourself. Is doesn't matter who you are, I'm just writing this down so I don't forget. I want to come back to that. It doesn't matter who you are. You should be, like I said, this is another example of low self-esteem or lack of confidence in standing up in front of people, having to talk, your physical appearance. Maybe you feel you're not very smart, you not have a lot of knowledge or education. It's not a bad thing. You just don't have a lot of knowledge or education. We've all been there. You will get more knowledge and education the longer you live, the more research you do, okay? And, you know, so there's a lot of different examples, right, for low self-esteem, lack of confidence. Let me tell you something. All that matters, knowledge doesn't matter. Going out into space doesn't matter. Politics doesn't matter. Education doesn't matter. Intelligence doesn't matter. All that matters is getting food. That's the whole purpose of our existence. When you simplify it, the whole reason we do anything, the art, the music, the video games, the work, the construction, the blah, on and on and on, all the different jobs, careers, all of that is just so that we can afford to get food to eat. I don't want to get into the whole thing about money, but that's all we need to do is eat. However you need to get the food, that's all that matters. It doesn't matter if you know about math or not, or science, or what's going on. You could live in a cave and have absolutely, and be a feral human being. And that's fine. That's really all that we need to do. And you go out of your cave and you get berries and you eat snakes, eat bugs, and you eat squirrels, whatever. That's all that, right? So, really, I know there's the whole reproductive aspect of our lives. That's the other reason why we're kind of here. But you don't have to reproduce if you don't want to. That's kind of a choice. But when it comes to eating and staying alive, you don't really have a choice. I mean, you could starve yourself to death. But, you know, what's the fun in that? I don't know, maybe that is fun. Maybe I should do that. Starving myself to death ASMR. Yeah, no, I'm just kidding. Anyway. But, so, just backing up and getting back to why I came here to whisper to you. So lifting your head up and walking, so that you are aware of your environment. And as you do that, you will have more confidence. It's kind of like you have to do these things to train, to train your brain and yourself, and to trick your brain, so to speak, into being more confident. So walk with your head up, keep your hands out of your pockets, so that you're always ready for anything. Not that you're always going to get attacked by someone, but just for any reason that you might need your hands at the ready. To pick your nose, right? Swat some flies away. Or to, you know, fight off would-be evil So if you have your head down and your hands in your pockets, you're a target. I'm sure you've heard that before. And then keeping your head up, you know, you get to see what's going on in the world. Now you don't have to look straight ahead at people. If there's people, if you don't still, you know, like for me, when I go on my walks or I go out to the store, I walk and I kind of keep my, head up, my arms out of my hands out of my pockets, my arms out of my pockets. Usually I keep my arms in my pockets. Yeah. So they're easily accessible. But I walk, like I said, I'm not the greatest people person. I am somewhat antisocial. So I kind of walk and I look down. I keep my head up, but I keep my eyesight down, kind of like this, not looking at the ground, but just kind of so I can still see with my peripheral vision, people, you know, everything that's going on. I'm kind of like looking, you know, down a little bit so I can see what's going on without looking at people or whatever. That's just what I do because, you know, so, and maybe that's what you do. So that's one thing, right? The head up, hands out of the pockets, you know, and that's one way to build confidence. Getting back to who you are if you feel insecure, lack self-esteem or confidence. Oh, another thing is don't let jealousy, don't let other people's financial wealth or their possessions, worldly possessions, make you feel less confident in who you are, okay? Because all this crap is just what it is. Like, fancy cars. Like, okay, that's great. You have a fancy house, a mansion, cars. You have a, you know, 20 cars. You have a $50,000 Mercedes. Okay, great. Well, you know what? You're probably an idiot for paying that much for that car. Well, you know, those people are probably idiots for paying that much for a place to live. So don't feel bad. You should actually probably feel bad for those people being dumb enough to pay for an overpriced method of transportation. A lot of people need, but see, I'm not really calling those people stupid. But those people, that's another example of overcoming insecurity. People need their jewelry and their expensive watches and their expensive suits and their expensive cars to feel confident because they don't feel confident for whatever reason. It's that comparing. So if you, you know, don't have a big house, if you have an old car, that's fine. It's just, and I'm sure you know all this already. Again, I'm not trying to talk to you as if you're stupid, okay? But we, as human beings, we put far too much importance on material possessions, status, when in the end, we're all gonna die anyway. You can't take that stuff with you. So, the car I have is a 2012 Honda Civic. I think it cost about $18,000. It's been paid off. And I'm gonna drive that thing for as long as I can, for as long as the engine and everything holds up. So it's already been 11 years, right? 2012, 2023, 11, yes. Questioning my math. So, you know, it's just a, it's a car, you know? So, but I don't want to get a whole thing about, but if you feel, but my whole point about material possessions is if you feel insecure or you feel less confident because you have, because you don't have shiny things, that's just really ridiculous, okay? And it has nothing to do with jealousy. It's just annoying. Like, great, you can afford a Mercedes, you can afford a mansion, okay? Whatever, you know, I'm not jealous. There's, you know, so there's nothing to be, there's nothing to be jealous of or feel insecure or lack of confidence by having a, you know, a job at McDonald's or whatever. So, anyway, I don't want to spend too much time on that whole thing about money and wealth and all that, but, so that's another thing is, so if you ever feel, I'm not trying to pity you or anyone, but I'm just saying if you happen to not have a lot of financial wealth or material possessions, nice car, it doesn't matter. I'd still be your friend. We'd still hang out. So, right, that stuff. And most people, like you and myself, I think we know that. There's plenty of people, plenty of us, that aren't into material possessions. And there are plenty of people that are. So, I don't want to start analyzing all that for the next 15 minutes. I spent too much time on it already. But that, you know, keep your head up. Keep your head up, keep your hands out of your pockets, right? Just be aware of your surroundings. When you walk past someone, you know, you can always just give them a glance and say, hello. If you're on a walk, you know, and it's just, you know, sometimes good, just do that. That's one way of building confidence. Don't worry about, don't compare, make comparisons about what you have. Don't let that make you feel bad about yourself, you know, that you don't have whatever, even if you have a YouTube channel, a small YouTube channel, right? There's always going to be people that have more. Even if I had a billion subscribers, there was going to be someone that has 10 billion. So you can't keep chasing more. First off, you don't need more. That's just a sign of being empty inside. When you're constantly more, 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 I need more. So that speaks a lot about someone. So be happy and content and confident when you walk, your head up, hands out of your pockets. Be confident in what you have or what you don't have. If you don't have a lot of wealth, that's fine, okay? You're not stupid. You just can't afford things. But having more, it's not like having this is the last thing I'm gonna say. It's not like having a Mercedes and a mansion gives you great physical health or something. Or like, it's all a mental thing. So, you can have all the money in the world and all that, but you're still going to end up with sickness and illness and death in the end. Okay, so enough about all the wealth, but hopefully, you know, it's not even a thought. Alright, so we talked about keeping your head up, hands out of your pockets. Don't worry about, you know, comparing what you have. It's true. The less stuff you have, the more confident you are, the more content, the more happy you are. The less you take in the news and social media and whatever, the more peace of mind you have. So I could go over a lot of different examples about less is more, but it's true. Less is more. Now, obviously, when it comes to healthcare here in the United States and affording a decent place to live, you kind of need more money a little bit. But, you know, so I'm somewhat anti-capitalist. So every time I start to talk about money, I want to go down these paths about money and everything, and I just don't want to do that. Okay, so that's the examples, right? Again, last time, keep your head up, hands out of your pockets, beware of your environment, you know, don't compare yourself, don't compare what you have or what you don't have to someone that might have, quote unquote, more than you. And the other thing that I wrote down earlier was, be confident in who you are. We are who we are. We can't change that. Well, we can kind of change that when it comes to gender. I know that can be a hot topic. Some controversy there. If I had, I have a son. But, you know, if I had a son or daughter, I have a son, but if I had a daughter or whatever, and they were going through this thing, questioning their gender, I don't know how I would handle that. So I don't want to get into that whole discussion, but people's choices are their choices. As long as they're making the best educated choice, speaking to professionals, and all that. So that's all I'm going to say about that. I kind of want to say, I don't think it's very natural to change your gender physically. That's a major surgery. But if someone feels strongly about that, I'm not going to, who am I to say anything? We all can do what we want with our bodies, so I'm going to leave it at that. But aside from the gender reassignment surgery thing, gender identity, we are who we are, and you can't really change that. You can change your beliefs, philosophy, your mindset, your education, your knowledge, right? You can gain more experience and knowledge, but some things we can't change, like our certain, like, personality, like, if you are a very anxious, nervous person, you're probably never going to be able to change that. If you are not good with directions, you're never going to be able to change that. If you're not, so there are some things that there's just, that we can't change. That we are hardwired, like at a genetic level, you know? So, alright. Been here for about 35, almost 40 minutes. Gotta bring this to an end. I wanted this to be like 20 minutes. Alright. So be confident. This is gonna be the final message. And I think this is maybe the most important message besides walking with your head up and, you know, not comparing what you have or what you don't have versus people that have quote unquote more. Be confident in yourself, in who you are. We are given these bodies. We're brought into this world. You know, right out of the factory press, we don't get to, you know, have any say. We don't have any say whether or not we even want to come into this world to begin with, right? So, and then we're born and we have whatever genetic personality tendencies and all of that. And so this is what we're stuck with. And this is what I'm stuck with. And so you just need to be comfortable in your own skin. You need to be comfortable with who you are at whatever point in time you are. So if you're 10 years old watching this right now, you need to be confident in being a 10-year-old, that you don't know a lot about the world. You're not very experienced, not very educated about, you know, compared to someone who's 30 years old. But that doesn't mean you're stupid. You're just young. You have just less knowledge, but you'll get there in time. So be patient and just be comfortable in your body and in your skin, okay? I want you to be confident and comfortable, you know, in your own skin. You might have those days where you don't. You just wake up and you just have one of those shitty kind of days for whatever reason. But if you're in school, elementary school, high school, just be confident walking down the halls. You know, keep your head up. You don't have to look anybody in the eye, but you can keep your head up and just kind of look, you know, angled down as you walk past, you know. So there are things you can do to change, to make you feel better about yourself. And I'm sure you do feel good about yourself most of the time, right? I mean, I know you do. It's not like you're insecure little blob all the time, okay? I doubt it, all right? I'm sure most of the time you don't even think about this, being not having confidence or lacking self-esteem. There's another plane. Another drone spying on us. Anyway, probably looking for Corvus or Margaret or Dave, Kevin, Benjamin, etc. Anyway, so be confident who you are. And when you have those feelings of low self-esteem or feeling insecure for whatever reason, just, you know, do whatever mental gymnastics you have to do, but without going to the extreme where you think, you know, you're the alpha male or the queen or all that kind of stuff, which I'm not trying to say. I'm trying to be nice here. I'm trying to be the better person compared to how I can be on Twitter. But that's what we do when you feel insecure. You balance the scale by trying to think that you're the greatest person in the world. No one is the greatest person in the world. We're all insignificant. But if you need to think that you're a king or a queen to overcome that these feelings that you hate, that you feel insecure, or people make you feel less confident, call you ugly, call you names, whatever. We've all been there in some way. People, doesn't matter who you are, doesn't matter how attractive or how quote-unquote unattractive someone is, it doesn't matter. People will always find a way to judge and call other people names. It doesn't matter. People are going to hate people. I hate people for my own reasons, not because they're attractive or anything, just the greed and the narcissism and the schemes and the reasons that I think are valid for hating people. So as we're winding down here, because I don't want to go another 15 minutes, helped me being more confident. Of course, I've aged as well, but I never wanted to be on camera. I always wanted to just be creative and artistic, but not being on camera. But I've kind of always been like a class clown and a comedian, actor. I mean, my bio says I'm an actor and a comedian, but I'm not an actor and a comedian in the strict sense. More of a homegrown, you know, internet actor, comedian. You know, I mean, I'm no George Carlin. I don't, I've always wanted to do stand-up comedy, but I don't have the confidence. I don't have the confidence to get in front of people. I don't like to write. To be a stand-up comedian, you kind of need to write and rehearse your stand-up gig and all that. But I don't want to travel. You have to do a lot of traveling as a musician and a stand-up comedian. I can't be bothered with any of that. No, thank you. Especially, I have a family. So, but when I was younger, 16, 17, I never had the drive to become an actor or comedian. Maybe someone should have directed me, pushed me in that way. I don't know. All right, so I gotta bring this to an end. So my whole point is, I hope you can find, if you're feeling lack of confidence, low self-esteem, just do what you can to bring yourself up, to feel better about yourself, because it doesn't matter what anyone thinks about you. What matters is what you think about you, and you should think good about yourself. Even if you have to think you are the greatest person in the world, as long as you don't adopt that attitude and look down at other people, right? That's not very healthy, because there is no human being that's better than any other human being, right? I mean, you could take an Olympic athlete, and I bet they don't know how to build a computer. Maybe they don't know how to play the piano, right? So you could get any person in the world that you think's the greatest person, Muhammad Ali, the greatest boxer of all time, right? I don't know. Name some person that's just so great, right? People will say a president, a Nobel Prize laureate, and you know, all these great human beings, but they're not really that great, right? Because they're just another human being. Number two, there are plenty of things that they don't know about or know how to do. So if you go into the biography, the About Me section of my channel, you'll see some things that I don't know how to do. I know how to make videos and try to make people laugh and tell jokes and be creative, right? And people call me creative genius and all that, right? And I can do all this stuff, edit videos, edit the audio, take pictures, blah, blah, blah. But there's plenty I don't know how to do, like masonry, plumbing, electrical work. I don't know anything about auto repairs. I don't know how to fly a plane. I don't know how to solve complex math or physics equations. Right? So, all right. But so, so we need to be confident in who we are. Be confident in our insignificance. Be confident in our imperfectionism. No one's perfect, in other words. So we need to be confident. Just be confident in who you are. No one's perfect. I'm not perfect. Right? There's no such thing as perfection. And, yeah. Alright, so I gotta end the video now. Almost an hour anyway. So I hope you got my message. I hope this helps you some way. And like I said, I know you're probably very confident already most of the time. But, you know, if there's just things you can work on, do some exercising, lift some weights. I used to lift weights. That helped a little bit. Gave me a little bit of a somewhat of a core. A little bit of definition, not much. I don't work out, I lift weights as much anymore. I don't have that kind of drive anymore. So, you know, just do what you have to do in a healthy way to be more confident about yourself so that you're more happier. And, you'll hopefully have less negative thoughts about yourself and things like that. Okay, so I don't really have a great big moral to the story ending here. Just hope that you can gain more confidence in yourself, whether you feel insecure and low self-esteem all the time or just at certain times and whatever the situation might be. Okay, and that's my message for today, for this video. Alright, so thanks for tuning in, thanks for watching. I wish you nothing but the best in being more confident and secure in who you are. And I hope to see you in another video real soon. And maybe years from now, we'll both still be here on this planet, in this simulation, dream, whatever this experience is exactly. And you'll be a little more confident in who you are and all that, if that's not the case right now. All right, so long, and take care for now.